So in such a manner, in the last session, we have seen about the n-tier architecture, 2-tier architecture, 3-tier architecture, and so on. So practically, what I have discussed, practically, it is very difficult to perfectly design an application. Okay, so how many tiers you want to use? Okay, without hampering your response time. And this is a design decision. So this particular decision should be taken very crucially and considering all pros and cons. Okay, pros and cons means advantages as well as disadvantages. So if you are creating an application, okay, that is n-tier application, then you have to consider number of advantages, okay, that is the pros parts, as well as you have to consider drawbacks. Okay, and if you have to balance it. Okay, in balance in such a manner that, okay, you should fulfill the needs of your design, you should fulfill the requirement of the client, okay, without hampering the response time. Okay, now one more thing is that, okay, application logic tier is also called as a business logic tier, okay, or business access layer. Okay, so in this particular diagram, they have shown it for a 3-tier architecture. If you closely observe this particular part, then it is having a presentation layer. It is called as a layer or presentation tier. Then logic, business logic layer or business logic tier. And the last is a data tier or a database tier. Right? So they have shown this particular part, okay, by using a diagram. You can take any diagram. Okay. This is one example, okay, in which they are maintained in the 3-tier architecture. In which they have storing the information of a student, that is the name, address, email, picture, and they have shown this particular one presentation layer interface also about the student information. Okay, so at the back end, they should maintain some table, they should maintain some relation, student relation, in which they are having some columns, that is the name, address, mail, and picture. And they can retrieve the data and they can show this data in the given table format, tabular format. Such type of application, we have seen it. Okay, by using a database connectivity, we have seen this application. Okay, when we have designed the swing part or we have seen the swing programs, right? In the swing also, we are having a 3 tiers, that is a presentation tier, application logic tier, and database tier. But the important thing, if you observe in case of swing programs, what we have developed, okay, in that case, we are having a presentation part as well as we are having an application logic part and as well as we are having a database part. Okay, so we have performed some database connectivity with the backend database. Okay, and we are having a application logic and presentation. So that particular swing application is the ideal case of 2-tier architecture. Why is it called a 2-tier architecture? In that case, we are having a presentation layer as well as application logic layer is present in a Java program, because in a Java program we are having an application logic. We are performing a event handling, okay, with the help of Java program. So we are having an application logic. At the same time, we are having a presentation part also. We are having some text fields, button, and so on. So client is interacting with these text fields or buttons. Labels, it means that we are providing the presentation logic with the help of Java program. It is possible. Okay, so presentation logic as well as application logic with the help of Java program, and by using a Java program we are connecting with the database. So database is some other application. It means that it is a 2-tier architecture, right? So presentation and application at one tier and database at another tier. So in this case, student generally confuses. Okay, so you are using your own laptop, or we are using our own laptop, okay, in your case also, and by using that particular laptop with the help of JDK, okay, you have created application. Okay, you are using some IDE, it is a different case, but important thing is that JDK, you can use any IDE, Eclipse, NetBeans, JCreator, and so on. सो कोणता आयडी वापरता हे महत्त्वाचं नाही, महत्त्वाची गोष्ट काय, JDK, ठीक आहे. विथ द हेल्प ऑफ JDK ऑन युअर लॅपटॉप यू हॅव क्रिएटेड प्रेझेंटेशन पार्ट ॲज वेल ॲज ॲप्लिकेशन पार्ट, राईट. अँड ऑन द सेम लॅपटॉप, ऑन द सेम मशीन, यू हॅव इन्स्टॉल्ड सम डेटाबेस, Okay, in our case, we have installed MySQL database, and with the help of MySQL database, we are storing some data. And our Java application is connecting with that particular database. And now you are saying this particular application, what we have created in case of Java SIEM, is a two-tier architecture. How is it so? Okay, we are calling a tier when we are having a separate machines. Baryas lokana doubt hai ki sir he asa kasa hou shakta, don tier kuthe hai, ekas tier hai. Okay, ata mahatvachi goshta hai, number of tiers hi goshta ki number of machines var dependent nahi. There is a no relationship between number of tiers and number of machines. This is a conceptual thing, remember this. Okay, this is a conceptual thing. So we are calling particular part as a tier when we have separated that part from our remaining part, then we will call it as a tier. Apan database sathi MySQL vaparto, te ek vegla application hai. Database data storage activity la apan aplya main activity pasun vegla kele application logic presentation sathi apan JDK vaparto, java vaparto. Yala java la apan te database pasun MySQL pasun separate thevla. फक्त एकच गोष्ट आहे की ह्या दोन्ही गोष्टी आपल्याच मशीनवर आहेत, आपल्या मशीनवर असल्यामुळे आपल्याला आय पी ॲड्रेसची गरज लागत नाही. आता समजा तुम्ही तुमच्या लॅपटॉपवर ॲप्लिकेशन लॉजिक बनवताय, प्रेझेंटेशन आणि ॲप्लिकेशन लॉजिक बनवताय JDKचा वापर करून, आणि तुमच्या मित्राच्या का मैत्रिणीच्या लॅपटॉपवर तुम्ही डेटाबेस ठेवला आहे आणि त्या डेटाबेसशी कनेक्ट होत असाल, तर त्या मशीनचा आपल्याला आय पी ॲड्रेस लागला असता. परंतु या दोन्ही गोष्टी आपल्याच मशीनवर असल्यामुळे, एकाच मशीनवर असल्यामुळे आपल्याला लोकल होस्ट देऊन आपलं काम भागतं. पण लोकल होस्ट म्हणजे काय, आपण आय पी ॲड्रेसच देतो एक प्रकारचा. पण ह्या केसमध्ये सुद्धा टू टीयर्स आहेत. का दोन टीयर आहेत? कारण आपण गोष्टींना सेपरेट आउट केलं आहे. तेव्हा महत्त्वाची गोष्ट, बरेच लोक कन्फ्यूज होतात नंबर ऑफ टीयर्स आणि नंबर ऑफ मशीनचा काय संबंध आहे का. नाही, जरी आपण एकच मशीन वापरली असेल, लॅपटॉप हा एकच आहे, फक्त एकच मशीन वापरली असेल, तरी कन्सेप्च्युअली वी आर युझिंग अ टू टीयर्स बिकॉज वी आर सेपरेटिंग आउट दिस थिंग्स. सो दिस इज द बेस्ट एक्झाम्पल हाऊ टू आयडेंटिफाय द टीयर. तेव्हा नंबर ऑफ टीयर आणि नंबर ऑफ मशीन्सचा काहीही संबंध नसतो. एका टीयरवर एकापेक्षा जास्त मशीनही येऊ शकतात, किंवा आताच्या केसमध्ये होती तशी एकच मशीन दोन्ही टीयरना वापरता येते. म्हणजे कोणासाठी? क्लायंट पार्टला पण वापरता येते, ॲट द टेम टाईम डेटाबेस पार्टला, सर्व्हर पार्टलाही वापरता. सो इट इज क्वाईट पॉसिबल. ओके, इट इज नॉट द केस दॅट ओके यू शूड हॅव सेपरेट मशीन्स फॉर एव्हरी टीयर. ओके, इट इज आयडियोलॉजी, दिस इज अ कन्सेप्च्युअल थिंग. कन्सेप्च्युअल आहे. कन्सेप्च्युअल ह्याचा अर्थ काय? आपण विचार करतो आहे त्या पद्धतीने. ओके, फिजिकली ते प्रेझेंट असायला कसं काही नाही आहे, फिजिकली प्रेझेंट असण्याची गरज नाही. सो इट इज अ कन्सेप्च्युअल थिंग. And you cannot have some restrictions on number of machine on a particular tier. It may have one machine or it may have n machines. It depends upon the application. I think now the idea is very clear to you about the number of tiers, number of machines and so on. So in this case, in this particular web link, okay, they have given a business access layer also, and they have discussed this business access layer. We have already discussed about it. You can just go through this particular web link. It is a good explanation of every two tier, three tier, and they have also given the advantages as well as disadvantages. Okay, so you can just go through these things. You can get some more information, and it is very good to answer your manual questions also. Okay, so I have shared the two web links. You can go through both the web links. Okay, you can find some more material on a Google. Okay, but okay, you first refer this material. It is very good. Okay, and it is explained in a simple manner also. Okay, you can go through the both the sessions. Okay, because it is a continuous thing. Okay, and you can try to solve some problems or try to answer the questions given in a manual. Okay, next session we will see the Java servlet part, okay, in detail. Thank you for watching this video.